Hi, I'm Scott Hanselman. It's another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Steve Lasker. We're talking about the Azure Container Registry, GAs.
We've got it now general availability, so people can start putting their production loads on it. And it's been quite fun as our own internal team start to put load on it. And we get to watch all the load, you know, how many people are pushing and pulling. It turns out there's a lot of activity that goes on to a registry.
Okay, so what is a registry and why do I need it?
So probably a best way to help there is we can kind of talk about this workflow here. People are working in a developer inner loop. Even in that inner loop when they're starting to build their first Docker images, where do you get your image from? Right? It might be a public one you have on Docker Hub.
Your base image, yeah.
Your base image. Or I might, as a company, have decided that we have our own content that we want to put in that image, and I don't want it public. Right? Think of GitHub Enterprise or the other kind of places where I want to keep things inside. So we can stand up a private registry in Azure. You can then control it with your AD credentials, so you can limit it to your team. And then even for your base pulls, you can pull your own image, but certainly when you're doing your builds, you could push to that registry, and it works right in your own data center, wherever your data center of choice is. So in fact, we have some new data centers that we've announced.
So to see if I understand this in the context of maybe what people already understand, if you make NuGet packages or NPM packages, you'll pull from a bunch of open source sources like NuGet.org.
Right.
But when you make your final product, secret magic startup product, you're going to put it on MyGet or some private enterprise hardened secure location. This is where the results of my build live in that my container registry, and I control it. It is my instance.
It is, you control who has access to it. It's what I call network close. So when you're doing your builds, you probably want your build agent network close to that in the same data center. So things just run faster, and so they're secure. It's faster, and then you can deploy them to your resources as well.
And this isn't a shared resource. This is mine. Right, I'm not have other people who are nearby are not in there with
me. Right, this is, you will do a look at it and you will only see your images.
Fantastic.
So why don't we take a look at some of that? And actually what's interesting here also is, and this is what's just cool about Azure, is containers are becoming, you know, just everywhere.
Yeah.
You know, when we first did .NET, it was like, okay, here's like the .NET console, here's the .NET web app, and then, you know, how long was it before .NET was in every technology that we talked about? And we're seeing that with the registry or containers as well. It's just, containers are becoming the unit of deployment, so you need a place to actually store your images.
It's interesting that you say that, because for many years I have said that, that Git was FTP for code. Now, in fact, Docker and containers in general is becoming FTP for your implementation, for your instance.
For your code and the environment, you know, so you can deploy it all.
It's the better way to move instances around.
Yeah.
And I'd like you point out here, you can run them in a number of different ways.
Right. So why don't we take a look at what we can do here. So we'll go to the portal, and we'll want to do a new registry. So we'll just kind of go it this way so people know where to find it, if it doesn't show up in their MRU. So we have the Azure Container Registry here, and we can create a new one. And we've got the blade here, and we can give it some name, Steve Last AZ Friday, for instance. And we will get a little validation glyph that says, is that name globally unique, which apparently, let's try that one again.
Is this going onto a VM or is this software as a service? Do I have to think this about is, that? What am I paying for?
Yeah, that's great. This is software as a service. So we are hosting the registry. You will just see it as an endpoint. There will be, for now, in the GA release right now, there actually is a storage account in your subscription, and that's what we actually bill on. We will be moving to a managed storage where you won't even see that in your subscription.
Nice.
So we've, as typical database things, we see people kind of going at the storage account directly. They're deleting it. They're messing with it. And then they wonder why the registry doesn't work. So we're going to help them with those kind of management layers. But for now, you will see that in your account.
What I like about this is that you it comes down to storage. Like, you pay for the storage, and that's intuitive. That makes sense to me. If I am pushing once a week, then I'll pay for one amount of storage. But if I'm doing CI/CD and I'm pushing hourly, then I'll certainly pay more. And
exactly.
That seems like a smart pricing model.
Exactly. So so here you see, you know, we have quite a few regions. This is part of going GA is, you know, we can go down in Australia, we can go to Canada, Japan, Northern Europe, wherever we want. So let's just, let's choose West Europe here for the sake of it. And we'll go off and create that. Now, I did turn on the admin. We'll show that when it comes up.
Okay.
So that's starting to provision. And if I take a look at the container registries, We can see the ones that we already have here. Mm-hmm. And we'll just zoom this up a little bit, and you can see I already had one in India, the one in Australia, put a little Kiwi thing in there. And
do they have UIs? Do they have front ends?
Ah, nice that you asked. So yes, we do. One of the things that we added just recently, because this was one of the things that people were asking, was how can I see my list of images that I have in my repository? So now we have a repository listing, and you can see the different ones that I have there. And
so a registry contains repositories, and repositories contain images that are tagged.
Correct. So if you notice, and you'll also notice that I have a couple of nestings there. So instead of a single nesting, I could actually create multiple nestings. So you might have your team. The bike sharing team was one of the demos we did recently. Mm-hmm. And you might have the POC, and you might have the web and the API in it. You might have the production version of it. You might have another team working on a whole other project, and you can just keep on nesting them down.
Okay, so I can partition those any way I want. So one registry, one set of repositories can then be managed with access control however I want.
Yep.
If I wanted to change my access control in some dramatic way, each group in my company could have multiple registries.
Right.
Totally up to me.
And so we also have the command line of it, so let's kind of show how some of that can be done there. So Azure Friday will create this one here. This is using the AZ CLI.
So you're doing the same thing you did in the portal, except now you're doing it at the command line.
Right.
I'm used to Azure VM create and Azure App Service create. You're doing it Azure Container Registry create.
Correct.
So it's intuitive. I already know how to make stuff or list stuff or delete stuff, I can do the same thing.
Right, and here we're focused on the Azure V2 CLI for the AZ CLI. So we'll see that go off.
I did some videos recently that people can check out to show you how to use Docker to bring down the Azure CLI Docker container. And you don't have to set up Python on your Windows machine. You can just run that in Docker right away, which is pretty slick.
Yeah, I mean, that's another example of where the Docker is just being used as this unit of deployment.
Indeed.
So if we come over the portal, we will see our registries. Let's kind of come back over here, and we'll look at all of our registries that are created.
So there's some of the ones you just made, yeah.
Yeah, so let's see if this one's done. All right, so let that one finish a little bit. But now we've got a registry, we want to push something to it.
Right.
So that's one of the things that we need to figure out. So the first thing you would need to do is, well, if I'm going to tag and push an image to it, well, I need to be authenticated to it.
Right.
So normally when you see a registry, when you're doing pulls and pushes, you just kind of say, I want ASP.NET Core or Microsoft/ASP.NET Core.
Right.
Docker assumes, if you don't specify, that it's going to go up to Docker Hub.
Right. When you say a moniker, ASP.NET Core, ASP.NET Core build, it's assuming the public registry.
Right.
Okay.
In this case, I want to redirect it to a private registry. Mm-hmm. And that's what I can do here. So actually, what I showed a moment ago, if you remember, I showed the admin stuff. Mm-hmm. So let's go and grab this one, let's just say. And I can go to the access keys here. Actually, let me go grab a different one. Let's go grab the Canadian one here for a second. And notice we actually have some rotation keys here, so I can use either one of these. Mm-hmm. This one's like kind of a special privileged one because there's really only one account. And we do have rotating keys. What we probably want is one that you can do permissions on.
Right.
Owners, read-only, so on and so forth.
Yeah, I don't want to share super user with everyone.
Exactly. So what we've done is we use the service principal model here. Mm-hmm. And we've, after the registry is created, we've given you that snippet that you could run. And it is kind of long, so I will go paste it over here in Notepad.
It is long, but it is written for you. And you're basically going to go and create for RBAC, role-based access control.
Exactly.
A new role with a password.
So we'll just kind of do that. And
highly
we'll,
secure.
Yeah, which we'll delete very quickly.
Of course.
So we'll go off and now create that service principal. And you could see the scope and all of that for that registry. And notice the role is owner. So in this case, but I could have also obviously done it as a different role. Mm-hmm. And the list of roles are on the docs there. So that'll give me the ability to have a username and password. Mm-hmm. And you kind of see the app ID is the username.
Right.
So I can use that to log in. Now, I need to log into this newly created registry. So we'll say Docker login. And the registry that we created here, what was it? Steve, last Azure Friday?
Yeah.
So we'll do that. And then for the username, and I could have done a dash u dash
sure,
p thing here.
Sure, of course, it could have just been Steve or whatever, but
we'll do
someone, someone has assigned their password and their information, some password.
Thank you.
Someone has assigned that password, and they log in once, and then they go about their business.
Right.
So, right, so now you're in.
Now I'm in.
So let me guess. If you type Docker images, you're not going to see the same stuff as before.
Actually, I would. Remember, so Docker images is actually looking locally.
Oh, okay.
Right, it's the local cache in my machine.
Okay.
So that's what I built against my local host here. This is just saying that when, and I can log into a couple of registries, right? I actually am logged into a couple.
Okay.
But now if I want to push images to it, let's say I want to take this web image that I've got here.
Okay.
And I just built this from one of our samples, and you can see there's the web latest. So what I would do is Docker tag web to be this URL, where is the name of our, here we go, this one right here. That slash web, and we'll just say version one.
Okay.
And now if I do Docker images, I have two of them.
Ah, okay. So repository, this, these are local. That's a remote one that is going to be, you're going to, and but you haven't pushed it yet though, right?
No, I haven't. But also notice the image ID is the same.
Right.
It knows the only thing different is a tag.
Right.
So now what I can do is say Docker push. And it'll now push that one to that registry. So what the Docker client knows, and this isn't, we didn't make any changes to the Docker client. Notice I'm actually using
so
all
Docker
the Docker CLI.
So doesn't know or care that you are talking to Azure?
No. It just sees that URL. Anything before the slash, it sees there's dots in it and goes, oh, that must be a domain.
Is it significant that it pushed all the layers? Did it take layers that it had pulled down from the public one and pushed it to the private one so that you have no dependencies?
Correct. So now I don't, all those layers are actually in my registry at this point. So that's kind of cool.
That is extremely cool.
So now if I go over to the portal, and which one did I use? By the way, I did the AZ Friday thing. So we'll come over here to...
I think you did Steve Lass. Yeah, you did. You did the Friday. You've got so many.
I know. I was messing with trying to show all the locations, and now we show repositories. We should see. Yep, there's
there
web.
Is.
There's one. In fact, if we make a change here, let's just kind of go over here and say hello world.
Okay. Version two.
And we'll just go build that here. Notice I'm building
the
release
mode.
Of course,
you're doing this in VS, and VS knows about Docker, and you can see the Docker compose. Your VS is calling the Docker commands for you and building that image. There it goes. So and boom.
It's done.
313.
So now if I look at Docker images, if I could spell it right. Did you ever create that shortcut?
313. No, I didn't. I should do that. Doggy, there's 313.
Right.
That's the one we just made.
So I need a tag. That Docker tag,
version.
Web. Let's grab latest, make sure we're actually getting latest. Yeah. I don't know if I did that before. And we'll call that 2, okay?
Yep.
So now we've tagged that one, and now all we'll do is push this up to our container registry, and notice layer exists.
Layer exists. It
all those previous layers we already pushed is there. It only had to push the code difference.
Very cool.
For the last one. And if we come over to the portal, we should see...
Web, and I should see 1, 2 when you click on
that's
it.
What I meant to do. Thank
one,
you.
1, 2. There it is. What if you click on the tag? What happens?
You see manifests. You see
there it is.
All kinds of other
all the stuff,
details.
That, the internals of what got stored.
Yeah. So it kind of looks like internals too, right?
So I can use this as a place I can push to myself, as you did manually. All that stuff that you did, that was a poor man's CI/CD.
Correct.
Visual Studio built it. Docker built the image. You pushed the image. That was what Visual Studio Team Services could go and do for us.
Correct.
And then now that you have that private registry, but it's close to your other Azure resources, you could then deploy that.
Right.
Very
pretty cool.
GA and available.
GA and available. Get started today. We'll have some new features coming as well, which we're pretty excited about. But this we wanted to get out and let people get started already.
Very cool. We're learning all about the Azure Container Registry here on Azure Friday.